you know anything about wine?
A little.
You're a lifesaver.
I'm Chris.
Sky.
Two sudden adventures.
It's a sudden adventure.
Walk of shame.
Hey, get away from my car, man. We don't want any problems.
Wait! Ow! God!
Hi, Luis.
Hello, Jenna. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine. What about you?
I'm doing great. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much for your time. And oh my God, what an intense movie. And we see like this little angel kind of girl becoming, oh my God, I don't want to spoil, but it was very intense. Well, let's start from the beginning. What attracted you to David's script?
Well, David wrote an amazing script. It's a fantastic thriller with all the elements that a good thriller should have, you know, suspense, excitement, surprise, anticipation, anxiety. When I read it, it did remind me of Rear Window, Hitchcock's movie, one of my favorites. Obviously, David, the script is something completely different, but it did have some of those elements, also the film Misery. So basically, it had all the elements of a good thriller and also, let's say, the inspiration from the masters. So I felt that I wanted to make it. I was coming from having directed Kidnap with Halle Berry, that it was a film that took place mainly inside of a car. It's a car chase. And this film presented a similar challenge because most of the film takes place in a house. There are very few locations and there are also very few characters. And that combined actually ended up being a great combination, you know, excuse the redundancy. So it could be done during the COVID pandemic. That's a film that we shot in the spring of this year. And the fact that there were so few elements, it made us producers, myself and cast, it made us believe that we could do it within the time and the limits, let's say, that we had to make the film.
Yeah, it must be very like been talking to a lot of like producers, directors. This is like filming the pandemic must be very give you like a limited resources. You know, I think it's need to be very cautious and I don't know if this is your biggest challenge that you had or you have any particular scene or any moment that you think it was more challenge for you as a director.
Right. No, I think that. You know, if you are careful, if you follow the quote unquote rules, you know, that the guilds have established, you know, if you are conscious and aware and professional, it is safe. You know, obviously there is always an element of risk, but you know, we get tested continuously, so that's not really the problem, you know. I think the problem is always something else, you know, in real life, if you want, you know, coming from the set and finding yourself in the same world, but everyone knows about it because we're all in the same boat right now. So what can I say? Regarding the film, I think the biggest challenge was that the film was shot in 20 days. So yes, with the pandemic, there are some protocols that makes the days slightly shorter. So, you know, you have 20 days, but it feels like slightly less than 20 days. So that was really the biggest challenge, that we have so little time for different reasons, actors availability, budget, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So basically you find yourself that you have to go to a set with everything very well prepared, with a very clear vision of what the film is going to be played on the set, because the smaller error could cause a huge problem because you just don't have room for error. So what it plays basically is that you have to prepare the film very well. And, you know, once you have that, you have the right team. And in this case, you know, I had a fantastic team, especially my DP, Juan Espiroz, with who I have worked in the past. We prepared the film together and, you know, it was actually a piece of cake getting it done.
Yeah. Yeah. And then also you have the cast is amazing, like to find the perfect Sky. Lily, she's like I said to you, she's an angel, but she becomes something else. How hard was to find her?
Well, Lily Crute, that is the actor who plays Sky, is just amazing. In real life, she's as sweet as Sky. You know, she's 20 years old, she's gorgeous, she's so generous, she is very smart, fresh, lively. So you meet her and you get that part of her. But then what happened also is that she's an amazing actor. And as such, she can really perform completely the opposite of what she is. So she can be very cruel, very violent. She can really snap and become a sociopath. And that's basically what we were looking for her character in the film. So I think when you have someone so talented like Lily, all of a sudden, you know, a character like Sky becomes real and vivid and completely, you know, like scary. That is what we needed at the end.
Yeah, you also have like John Malkovich and Frank Grillo. I love both of them. They are really good actors, and the way that John Malkovich plays this character is so I was like, oh my God, that's so cool. And Frank Grillo, I wasn't expecting him because I usually don't watch the trailers before watching the movie. I was like, oh my God, I wasn't expecting him. How was like work with them and bring them on board?
Well, both of them came on board after having read the script and knowing the package of the film, let's say the producers, who the actors were going to be, that I was going to direct. And it was just amazing because they basically came to support Lily Krug and Cameron Monaghan, the two young actors in the film. So to have John Malkovich and Frank Grillo coming to your movie, you know, is just amazing. Both of them, they are incredible in very different ways. They're very different, I want to say, but equally incredible. And they're able to bring to every take, every performance, they bring something that you don't expect. And what you were saying with Frank Grillo, I mean, he can play the villain or the hero. When you see him in this movie, you don't know at the beginning who he's playing. You know, it takes a little bit to find out, like, oh, so this is what you're about. But again, the levels that he has in his performance, it just continues amazing you as the spectator. You just keep surprising you with something deeper and bigger. And the same applies for John Malkovich. I mean, he has a very interesting character that he played, that he pushed to the limit. And it's just really funny, quirky, and creepy. So it was just wonderful having both supporting Lily and Cameron.
Yeah. You always, like, you also directed like two of my series that I love it a lot, White Lines and Snatch. And what do you like the most, like directing series or direct a movie? I think both are different, but you must have something, both of them must have something that attracts you the most.
Yeah, well, in this case, it was very easy. I mean, White Lines is from the creator of Money Heist, La Casa de Papel, Alex Pina. So that was all that you need to know. So yes, it's a fantastic series. And when I got the opportunity to be part of it, I say, of course, you know, it's a great project. And a little of the same happened with the Snatch. I mean, the Snatch is, you know, it's a TV series based on the Guy Ritchie movie, Snatch. So again, another of my favorites. So there wasn't that much to think about it. Shooting films is different than shooting TV shows, but it's equally, how can I say, you know, it's equally fun to do both of them. You know, I don't think one like more important or more special than the other. I think they're just different. Movies, you tend to work more with your team, with your director of photography, with your actors. In series, you work with another set of directors, with showrunners. It's almost like a bigger project, and obviously it is, because you are usually part of 10 episodes or 20 episodes or more. So there are more elements to keep in mind and more people involved.
Yeah, and then for us to wrap it up, aside from Shatter, that everybody's going to be able to see pretty soon, what else you have, what new projects you have coming up this year for you?
Well, this year I will be having a thriller in Spanish shot in Ciudad de Mexico, Toda la Sangre, with Ana Brenda Contreras and Aaron Diaz as the protagonist. So that will be a lot of fun. And also, I just finished shooting Vampire Academy, that is a TV show from the makers of Vampire Diaries, Julie Blake, and Margaret McRuthe. So that should be coming up next year.
Yeah, exciting year. Luis, that's the time that I have with you. I just want to thank you so much for your time, a lot of success, and keep bringing all these excited projects to us. Because I think I like your style.
thank you so much.
Muchas gracias.
A ti, gracias. Ciao, ciao.
Ciao, ciao.
Ladies, you're 2 weeks behind on the rent again.
You're not gonna say anything? Explain where you were all night?
I saw something on the news.
Lisa!
It's your roommate. Scott, you should probably contact the police.
That would be stupid of me.
Why?
Expecting a package?
How's the knee, dude? I do good work, don't I?
Everything goes, lover boy. Stripping down to the studs.
All of this was a setup.
Now you're catching on.
Sky, you are a very naughty girl.
That's scary, right? I need all your passwords and security code. What's your mother's maiden name? Mother's maiden name! Are you going to get Chris or you want me to call the police? He's right here.
Daddy!
What did he want?
Okay, you're okay. Get you out of here.
Please state the nature of your emergency.
My name is Christopher Decker. There's a woman in my house. She's imprisoned me against my will. She's trying to steal my identity. She wants to kill me.
Thank God you came back, Chris. Thought I might lose you forever. All better now?
You should have seen the look on your face.
Stay back.
Afraid of the dark?
I love the dark.
If you like this video, don't forget to comment, to like, and subscribe to our channel right here.